don't like Yasir Qadir. Yasir Qadir is a kafir. Listen, did you listen that? Yasir Qadir is kafir.
Na'man Ali Khan is even worse. He's even worse.
This guy doesn't even know. Stop bringing American scholars.
So, scholars after scholars are just American scholars.
Are you
sure? Yes. Are you very positive about it?
No, there are three doctors.
Are you very positive about it?
There is one Allah and
three doctors. Why are you smiling when you lie?
Stop.
Why are you smiling when you lie?
Ahad means the one.
Ahad means one of.
One of, since when this, you know?
Since your scholars are telling us and that's our
answer. Which scholar says that it's one of?
You want to hear?
I know nothing.
One of.
It's one of.
They're going to get
Yasir Qadir.
You know who's his scholar? You don't like Yasir Qadir? You don't like Yasir Qadir?
No.
Yasir Qadir is a kafir. Listen, did you listen that? Yasir Qadir is kafir.
Okay, Yasir Qadir
he
is
might be kafir.
Why is he kafir?
He might be kafir.
Why is he kafir?
He might be kafir.
Listen.
He might be kafir. But you know, he still qualifies to talk about Islam from Medina unit.
He can do kufr without being kafir. He says that there is the Quran is a kafir. First of all,
I know I'm getting my back.
The Quran is a kafir.
He is right. He's right.
So he's closer to you than me.
He's closer to you than me.
Be quiet.
According to your scholars, it is one of.
One. Thank you.
One of.
Na'man Ali Khan is even worse. He's even worse. This guy doesn't know.
Stop bringing American scholars.
So, scholars after scholars are just
American scholars.
He's not an American scholar. He's a Muslim scholar.
Okay.
And Muslim scholar is telling us Ahad
Na'man Ali Khan. Okay.
Okay. So since we figured out, according to your Muslim scholars, Allah is one of, right. Can you be kind enough and then tell me,
right.
I don't care what Yasir Qadir does, right. I care what he says,
so I can come
and that someone who studied from the Medina University, someone who is teaching Dawah is a kafir now, go and deal with it.
Of course,
I want to take the opportunity.
This is Russia and America.
I want to take the opportunity. He says China. Don't lie about
it. No. He said Russia and America. Be quiet in his conversation.
I want to bring this to everyone's attention.
So we were discussing the story of Dhul-Qarnayn and Ya'juj and Ma'juj. Sighar al-A'yun, they have small eyes. And it is as if their faces are like a shield that has been hammered. So the descriptions that he gave have led many of the earlier Muslims to think that they are a race of the people of the Far East. And he said that their clothing is made out of wool or fur. And this is something also a hallmark of the people of the Far East.
Since Yasir Qadir is identified as a kafir by Muslims, he needs to watch out. From now on, his life is in danger. Yasir Qadir, watch out. Your Muslim brothers are not going to be nice to you. So, now, scholars after scholars, and the dictionary after dictionary, they identify Ahad means one of. I don't care you butchered him, sliced him and then put it in the cage. I don't care whatever you've done to him. But right now, I am very much concerned what is going to happen to him. When you publicly identified him as a kafir, I want to reach to the wherever he lives. All the FBI people, protect Yasir Qadir from the Muslim people. Protect him from the Muslim people. Now, since Ahad has been explained as one of, Allah is one of something, let's ask the question. One of what?
I have no problem
let's
in
listen.
Watching it. Can you be quiet? I'm trying to listen to a video.
Actually, one is really not a good translation of Ahad. Wahid means one. So how come Allah doesn't say, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ وَاحِدٌ Ahad is used negatively only. It's not used in a positive sense. It's only used not anyone at all. وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا Let no one at all commit shirk with Allah. Not no one at all. So that ahad is an absolute negation. That's where ahad is used. It's not used in a positive. When you want to speak in the positive, use wahid. When you want to speak in the negative, you use ahad, especially the exclusive, the absolute kind of negative. That's the first thing. But the thing is, in this surah, ahad is not being used in the negative, it's being used in the positive. So it's already unique. It's not something that normally happens in Arabic. The second place ahad is used is in idafa. Ahadukum. Ayawaddu ahadukum. Right? Would any of you like? Ahadukum, when it's one of. One of. One of.
Exactly. Okay, that's what we said earlier. Okay. So Allah uses ahad. Now, show me the references where ahad is used as one of as well as one. So we are trying to figure out the word ahad is used as one and one of in the different parts of the Islamic teachings. Because we heard a Muslim scholar who expressed ahad means is one of. He's a scholar. I am sorry. I'm not sorry actually. He committed zina. He should repent. I am sorry that you are hiding his sin under the carpet.
Not hiding his sin, he exposed another person's sin.
You expose the sin so that light will shine. You expose the sin. You will Lord Jesus Christ, as the light of the world, steps into the darkness to expose the sin.
Okay, so in this sentence, Huwa is the subject.
So where are you reading that from? Which scholar is telling you that? Or which dictionary?
Any Arabic expert can explain.
So I went to Arabic experts, as Yasir Kadim and Norman Ali, and you discredit them already. So you don't tell me like whatever Arabic expert you go. I want you to find the word ahad is being used, and then show me as it is used as one and one of.
One eternity later.
I'll help you. Word ahad is used in Surah 16, verse 76, as one of them.
Okay.
Open Surah 16, verse 76. Verse ahad is used in Surah 16, verse 58, as one of them. I'm telling you, sir, just check it out. Okay? Which one are you asking? So 1676 as one of them.
Okay.
No problem.
76. So verse 6, Surah 16, verse what?
Surah 16, verse 76. Surah 16, verse 58. Surah 15, verse 65. Surah 17, verse 23. Surah 18, verse 19. Verse after verse, word ahad is one of. Whatever Allah one of, Allah is not going to give you eternal life. Whatever Allah is one of, remember according to Islam, it is Muhammad gives you eternal life if you give him what is between your legs. All I can say is, run away from Islam, run away from Allah, turn to the Lord Jesus Christ, who loved you enough to give himself for you. Father loved humanity enough, Father loved humanity enough to give his one and only son, for his one and only son, that one and only son gave his life for us. Turn to him in repentance, his arms are open, he wants you, he loves you, and he wants to share life with you.